Hey, subscribing and liking the vids does go a long way on the channel, but what if you want to support me even further? Then I have something for you, acolytes. I have a Patreon with 4 tiers going up to £30 is the max, so easily affordable, and if you want to go a step further. Subscribing to my Patreon will give you many special benefits like early access to my videos and behind the scenes content, so you are getting many gifts in return for supporting me and the channel. So the link is in the description, and thank you for helping me in the long run. Let's get on with the video!
Greetings!
Welcome back to another classified U-file.
Today, we are investigating an event, creature or group.
But a certain monument that was created in a time of fear that will guide others into the future.
We're going to be headed down to...
Georgia, USA.
Let me show you how it's done. Johnny, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard. Cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals at heart. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold. But if you lose, the devil gets your soul.
Welcome to Georgia, home of its sweet peaches, the largest drive-in restaurant in the world, the Varsity, the invention of Coca-Cola, several beautiful state parks, and the birthplace of the civil rights movement, along with the man himself, Martin Luther King Jr. Along with many folk that despise all that, Southern state after all. But we will be dipping into Elbert County, where a mysterious yet strange monument once stood, the Georgia Guidestones themselves, made of full granite and stood at 19 feet tall 3 inches and weighed over 200,000 pounds, just like your mum. The structure was known to be called the American Stone Hens and opened on March 22, 1980, unveiled by Congressman at the time, Doug Barnard. The structure first came to mind by a man who under a pseudonym called Robert C. Christian, who decided to erect this structure on the behalf of a small group of Lower Americans, doomsday preppers basically, those extra nutty ones. And one of the reasons it was built was in a time of fear of a pending nuclear war. So this mysterious structure was preserved as a future guidebook, hence the name Guidestones, if that event ever occurred. We have many interesting rules for future generations to read from. Robert C. Christian and his strange benefactors behind the monument wanted certain rules to help the future of mankind if they were survived nuclear fallout if it was ever to occur. These are the guidelines that have made people wonder and create theories about the strange structure. 1. Maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. 2. Guide reproduction wisely, improving fitness and diversity. These are the two rules that struck fire with most people due to their similarities to what eugenics and population control are described as. It is just another crazy theory as less people have sown to heal the world, like throughout the pandemic for example. 3. Unite humanity with a new living language. 4. Rule passion, faith and tradition, and all things with tempered reason. 5. Protect people and nations with fair laws and just courts. 6. Let all nations rule internally, resolve with external disputes in the world court. 7. Avoid petty laws and useless officials. 8. Balance personal rights with social duties. 9. Prize truth, beauty and love, seeking harmony with the infinite. 10. Be not a cancer on the earth, leave room for nature, leave room for nature. So these are the rules, how strange they may be, are helpful with nature and a good guide to lead mankind into survival. But as it came about in a mysterious way, this has led to certain folk make up all kinds of tales and conspiracies. So you may be wondering why I mentioned them in past tense.
That mysterious structure, the monument often called America's Stonehenge, the stones were inscribed with 10 guiding principles, each etched in stone using languages from around the world.
Yeah, it doesn't exist anymore due to these kind of people who are out to get it.
So I'm going to break down a subject so incredibly important, I don't even feel worthy to bring you this information.
Where Republicans didn't have a voice, I in particular had no voice, having no committees, being stripped of them.
Thousands of people, and it will only get worse. It would never have happened with me as your commander-in-chief.
Results for gay, 172. Results for heterosexual, 2. One of the two books is actually Speak No Evil, Heal No Evil, which is about a Nigerian gay boy. Lesbian, 84. Jesus, 19, but half of them are about Muslims.
So ever since the Guidestones were built, and probably even before they were created, some locals from the area, or more say God-fearing folk, refer to the stones as the devil's work, along with a local minister in the area warning that occult groups would routinely visit the site and that a sacrifice was imminent. Not gonna lie, sounds pretty base actually. Later throughout the year, it would also be vandalized with graffiti. In 2008, it was sprayed with the words, New World Order. No, that's a different kind of New World Order. Further symbolizing people's fear of the monument being satanic and having evil around it. In a 2009 Wired article though, it was noted that a sandblaster by the name of Charlie Clamp, who spent countless hours on the etching, says he was constantly distracted by strange music and creepy disjointed voices. This was the only time though when someone claimed this. In 2022, a Republican candidate for the Georgia primary by the name of Candace Taylor attacked the stones in a campaign ad calling them satanic and calling for the Guidestones to be removed. Sadly, later that year, the unthinkable happened. Clearly due to Candace's remarks and constant attacks over the years, the reason why it's not there anymore is due to an explosive device that was set off on July 6th, and the local government tried its best to fix it up, but sadly had to take it down and close the site. There are a possibility of it returning sometime in the future, and the remains are donated to the Elberton Granite Association. This concludes the story of the weird and mysterious Guidestones that were a source of conspiracy when in fact was just a helpful guide if Armageddon was ever to occur. But were these people right and there was something far more sinister about these stones? Sadly, we will never know due to their paranoia. This ends another U-File, but there's many more to unravel where we explore the unknown and explain the unexplained. See you next time on the U-Files.